He said, and there shall be signs in the sun and in the moon and in the stars, and upon the earth distress of nations. I do not want to sound like a preacher of gloom, but things are going to get worse before they get better. Because the Bible says they are. And if there is a passage of scripture that describes this present age, this one is. Distress of nations. With perplexity, the word perplexity means a problem without a solution. Who can solve the problem of Vietnam? Who today can solve the problem of India? Beginning to stir awake with its 800 million population. Who can solve the population explosion? Who can solve the terrible crisis of money that is threatening to engulf the entire world in economic crisis? Who can solve the communistic efforts to engulf the whole world in slavery? Distress of nations with perplexity. It said the sea and the waves roaring. So this passage means the nations and the peoples of the nations roaring in discontent. the Son of Man coming in a cloud with power and great glory. And this is speaking of the second coming, when he'll set his feet bodily upon the Mount of Olivet in Jerusalem, and it'll cleave to the east and the west. And he'll come back personally with his saints with him. I plan to be in that number. And he said, when these things begin to pass, begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. Jesus uttered these words 2,000 years ago.